Dear David, I'll let you in on a secret. As a little girl, I never dreamed about my wedding. I never imagined the white dress or the flowers. I never chose a first dance. It didn't seem possible to dream of those things without knowing who I would walk down the aisle to. Now, today is beyond anything I could have imagined. But it seems so natural and real that I commit to a lifetime of partnership with you.
Rushed in late to chapel. Some things never change. Example, my penmanship. We went on many adventures to the Smoky Mountains, Mexico, treks in the woods, and an expedition across Europe. In the midst of this, we met our fair share of troubles and pains. However, we have always found the strength within ourselves and each other to keep moving on together. And so, this brought us to today, our wedding day.
When I met you, that wedding I never dreamed up came to life. You have become both my adventure and my home. Your love is restorative and brings me freedom. Today, I promise to follow you anywhere.
As one loves certain obscure things, secretly, between the shadow and the soul. I love you as the plant that doesn't bloom, but carries the light of those flowers hidden within itself. And thanks to your love, the tight aroma that arose from the earth lives dimly in my body.
In the fall of 2011 on the campus of Franklin College. As campus minister intern, David was charged with overseeing the freshman Bible study for the semester. Now, David worked hard at getting good leaders and preparing a solid curriculum for the incoming freshmen to join in the Bible study classes. But David didn't stop there. No, He did a fantastic job recruiting as well. All the incoming freshmen to join the Bible study classes, including an enthusiastic journalism student from Avon. A few weeks went by, and you could tell that he was pleased with how that class was going. But he had a little extra bounce in his step, and I noticed it one day, and I said, "Who is she?" David, will you take this ring and place it on Olivia's finger and repeat after me? This ring is a token.
This ring is a token.
Of my faithfulness.
Of my faithfulness.
And my love.
And my love.
And a symbol.
And a symbol.
That all I have.
That all I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
And place on David's finger and repeat after me. This ring is a token.
This ring is a token.
Of my faithfulness.
Of my faithfulness.
And my love.
And my love.
And a symbol.
And a symbol.
That all I have.
That all I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
David, you may kiss your bride.
We will run and free. You will dance with me. We'll fulfill our dreams and we'll be free.
Yes, a lot of our like shenanigans and whatnot have really have shown me how serious David is. Just how awesome his outlook on life is, how positive he is, and how willing he is to share in the hard times and the fun times. He's someone that you can always count on, and everything he does it with a very, very humble heart.
A little known fact, Olivia, Mallory, and I kept a blog in high school that we used not really to talk to anybody else, but just to communicate with each other. This was kind of like early text message days, so like I don't think I had texting. We mostly called each other. So these posts were like very deep. And she was in ninth grade when she wrote this, so I'm just going to share this with you so you can get an idea of where she was at that time in her life. My name's Olivia. I write, I read, I draw. My favorite animals are pandas and dogs. I am a pacifist and a tree hugger. I am a Pokemon master. And I love my best friends. So, we loved you then, we love you now, and I'm so glad you have someone in David who will love you forever.